you know much about the player's situation?
He looked really serious at the start. You know, I'm not a medical person, but it didn't look good. And by the looks of the people that were caring for him, it didn't look good. At the end, his eyes were open, and he acknowledged. I said a couple things to him, and he acknowledged me. So that's all I can base. Yeah, yeah.
Tucker, okay?
Yeah. They felt he was. Yeah. Obviously it shakes you up when something like that happens. You don't want that to happen to anybody. But he's a winner, and he knows. You know, in the game, those things happen. So, but I know he hurts for the young man. So.
Does that, you know? He's just played a great football game, and you want to celebrate and everything, and then that happens. How do you sort of handle that with your guys?
I think everything happens for a reason, you know, and so it's an opportunity for me as a head football coach to say, you know, this isn't the most important thing in life. You know, we get to play football. Hopefully we play hard and we get close to our potential and we get to win. We get to win once in a while. We get to move on, but we're learning lessons and we're growing as men, and so I think it's I'm not excited we have that kind of a lesson, but we use it in a positive way. So I told the guys in the locker room it was a bit of an awkward ending, but they needed to be proud of how they played.
Whose idea, for lack of a better word, was it to just end the game at that point?
Not sure, Justin. Do you know where did that come from? To end the game, was it the officials or?
The officials asked us and then wanted to work with the coaches, and we all agreed, really, from Delaware's perspective, how they wanted to handle it.
Okay. As far as the game, I mean, your team had sort of a built-in excuse or whatever to come out flat or not start well, be rusty, and none of that was there.
I don't know how to spell the word rusty, and you guys keep bringing it up, so.
You said they might be rusty, too.
No, I didn't. I said we're a well-oiled machine. So I do know this. In the spring, when we had the spring season, our guys came back for 3 weeks during Christmas vacation on their own and worked out. And then a week early before school. And so they don't take a break. They know what to do with their bodies, and they know when we practice hard. We conditioned this week twice. They had a voluntary conditioning on Sunday, so I think they came out and what did Mason say? Maybe one play, and then it was good. I mean, this is an imperfect game. I mean, we could win a national championship someday, and we're still going to watch the film and go, you know, dang, we can get a lot better. So we played pretty well at the start, I thought.
Well, you had talked about just how valuable it would be to have those 2 weeks to rest, and that your guys would be as fresh as they would ever be in December because of it. Was it evident to you that did pay off? Did you guys look a little more rested, explosive, you know, physically ready to go?
Yeah, it was noticeable, and it wasn't just noticeable in terms of the physical rest, the mental grind of fall camp and then 12 or 11 weeks straight. We had told them they could go home in the bye week, and then we realized we might be on a TV show on Sunday, so we had to change that. That was poor planning on my part. But these guys are unbelievable. And they love our family and they love their family. So everything worked out, I think, just the way it was supposed to.
Did Zach give you any clue, or did you have any idea that the quarterback run game might play so prominently in this game again?
Again, the run game should have been a huge part of it based on their scheme. And those two safeties they use, I'm not saying everybody can take advantage of it. Those two young men are good players. The two guys... 29-1 are the primary tacklers to make up for the guy in the front, and we just put it on our wide receivers and tight ends. We need to block those guys, and then I think it's, as a defensive coordinator, it's really hard to stop quarterback run in the first place, and then you take a guy out of the front. So I think it was natural. It was a natural progression to run quarterback. So.
Big for his confidence moving forward, though. Obviously, you didn't need to necessarily run him that much during the regular season, but it is a nice thing to have moving forward. And as long as it's been since he's had a run like that, is that a big thing for him moving forward?
Yeah, I think anytime you have a positive play, you know, I thought he played really well in the pass game, too. Made some great throws. The one that I know he wants back was the post to Jaden down by the goal line, but. There's no doubt that he broke us down. I thought he played a really, really good football game.
even when you did pass, it wasn't a lot of verticals. Sometimes, you know, obviously going to the outside, just quick passes. I mean, did the way that they schemed their defense impact that as well, just how you play the passing game towards the outside?
Yeah, their defense is really hard to figure out, you know, because those guys end up in different places. They slant, they do this, they do that. And they did some additional stuff. But we asked our coaches, what is the thing that's most consistent in their defense? And we thought the outs or the, you know, what you're talking about, the sideline throws were. And then we always tried to have a layered effect over there too, you know, so that if they didn't have a soft spot, we'd at least maybe able to throw it in behind. You saw that happen a couple times. So the one to Landon was a great example of that. That's a tough scheme. That's a really tough scheme to move the ball against.
There's quite a few runners on the team that once they get to the second level, I mean, you know, you can do some damage. I mean, how often has it been this year where, you know, sort of like this game, the way the offensive line is playing, it's almost a given that they're going to get there. They're going to get past that initial line and get into the second level.
Yeah, I don't know if it's a given. I would credit, I mean, we've got a good offensive line. And so in football, they get 11, we get 11. I'm not trying to be remedial here, but in theory, there should be one guy left to tackle if the guys are doing maybe two because he's your quarterback. And then if you have a scheme that you can take advantage, maybe the one guy that's supposed to tackle you that's free is over here and you're running here. And then you have a guy like Isaiah Davis that doesn't get tackled lots of times. So, I mean, there's a lot of things that come into being able to run the football. I thought we had great schemes, and I thought we blocked their tacklers pretty well. And they ran a lot of blitzes that we didn't expect. We didn't expect that much blitzing, and then we had to just do some adjusting a little bit.
I have time for two more questions for Coach.
You talked a little bit about how the 2 weeks off helped everybody, but it seemed like Isaiah Davis kind of came out with a little bit of an extra burst at the beginning. How much did those 2 weeks help him in particular?
Well, if there's a guy on our football team that I kind of referenced guys taking care of their bodies, if there's a guy that's a picture of that or a definition of that, it's Isaiah Davis. And it's all the time. You know, it's sleep. It's as a true freshman during the season, he would go to the wellness center and do extra workouts, as I found out. So, I mean, he's a guy that football is very important to, and he's worked very hard to get to where he is. And he's a good football player.
John, how do you think your team is handling the expectations, the pressure? I mean, this is the first time you've been really in this position.
Yeah. I think they're handling it very well. I think after we beat North Dakota State and we were ranked number one, I think there was an awkwardness or how do we deal with this? You know, we're married now. How do we, you know, we built a house. How do we get, you know, and it said the new deal. But after that, we were lucky enough to stay there, so it became not something we assume or we boast about, but it's what's on it's the label. And I remind them, all right, if somebody's going to call you the number one team in America, then you better play like the number one. Much is given, much is expected, you know, and they've responded, and primarily in practice, honestly. I don't have any friends, so I'll sit here and talk all night. You know, so.
One comment on the defense. I don't think we've talked about the defense yet. Another team that comes in flying high and you basically shut them down. How about the defense?
Well, we play so much defense, yet Jimmy and his coaches keep it really simple. And so I really think they have great weapons. They have great skill on the outside. Their starting quarterback, who I should have mentioned that too, is unfortunate that he went down. But I think he had trouble maybe figuring out where do I throw the ball here, and then it's really hard to run against our defense. Guys are fresh and they're aggressive, and we're still playing with maybe without our best player in Adam Box, so can't wait to get him back, and I know he can't wait to get back. So we play a lot of guys. You know, you saw that we play a lot of guys on defense. So.